my car, man, I'm gonna smile. I got to get away, you just for a while. I'm gonna go for a ride, I'm gonna take my time. Maybe just one day, I got to run away.
Welcome to this week's Down the Shore.
Today we're going to visit the Ortley Fish Market. We're going to go in and see Nanette and Rose, and we're going to discuss seafood and maybe even some sea life that's indigenous to this area. They also may give us some tips and some recipes on how to cook some seafood. We're also going to see some live lobsters.
Yeah, I'm going to learn how to shuck clams, and so stick around and we'll have fun.
Okay, we're inside with the owners, and we have Nanette and Rose. They're going to tell us a little bit about their selection that they have tonight. Okay, shrimp is one of my favorite foods.
Salt.
See, I have some. soul. And what do we have?
And this is salmon, Norwegian salmon steaks.
They cut like that. Is there a particular reason?
That's the steak. Okay, Matthew, put this together like this.
This is the whole fish.
This is the fish.
Okay.
And you'd have the head over here, and then you'd have another part down here. And usually toward the tail end, that's where they usually fillet it, because there's less bone. And it's easier to clean the bone out. Steaks have bone in it, but it's very good for grilling. It holds up very, very well on the grill.
And salmon's really a healthy fish for you. It's high in omega fatty acids.
Yeah. Yeah, the cholesterol that helps lower your cholesterol.
Right, good cholesterol.
Yes. Good cholesterol.
Yeah, it's very healthy. This is tuna. Fresh tuna. And it's dark like that. It's red. It turns white when you cook it.
It was going to be my next question, because I know in the package when I get it, it's white.
Yeah. Yes, it turns white. And if you wanted it to, like, tuna in a can, you have to boil it. You have to boil that. Most of the people down here use the grilling. Cut it in steaks. Barbecue it. And what you would do is you turn your grill on high. You get it good and hot. And then you lower it, put it on medium. And you take that and throw it right on the grill like you would a hamburger. And you flip it like a hamburger with a spatula.
And it's really quick cooking. It's like 3 to 5 minutes on your side cooking stuff.
And to taste line it out, do you put spices on it? Do you just leave it?
Well, it's good to marinate Italian dressing or in a like a ginger teriyaki. Very good with ginger teriyaki. Yep. And here we have our
actual
whole fish.
We actually have
actual fish.
With eyes.
Here.
This here.
Pull them out for you. It says sea bass.
And this is Morgie. We've got live at the Ortley Fish Market. Morgie and bass.
I like that. That's good. And,
this is also a local fish, Morgie.
A lot of these fish are locally in this area, but not all year round. So there's different times that, right.
This is Florida Red Snapper.
That's
pretty.
And this is a blue.
The blue fish looks like. Which one is this, Ro? Because the eyes, it's hard to tell.
I think that one's a fluke.
Fluke.
Oh, okay.
Okay. The flukes and the flounders, they look very, very similar, but it's hard to tell the difference sometimes because it depends on where the eyes are. It's which side.
I think on the, I'm not positive about this, but I think the flounder has one eye on the top and one eye on the bottom, where the fluke has both eyes on top. Or the flounder has both eyes on top and the fluke has one on each side. I'm not, I still get confused with that one.
More than I do.
This is cod.
Okay.
This is whiting.
That's like that smoke whiting. That's what it looks like before they clean it with smoke.
This is a nice whitening. And there's only one bone, especially for people that don't like to eat fish with bone, there's only one bone in there. And if you could actually eat the meat off the bone, and you will get
a
little
splinters. It's like a triangle. The bone is a triangle.
Now, do you sell these like this?
Yes.
Do people actually buy?
Yes, and we clean them and gut them and any way you want them.
Why would you buy, ask Mike, why would you buy a whole fish?
Well, to grill, they put it on the grill hole. It really gives a nice appearance, and the fish is really a lot tastier on the bone. Because you get the moisture from the bone.
If you can handle all that other stuff, it's worth it.
Right, right. Once you can get past the other stuff, it's pretty.
Something I wouldn't want to actually do. But.
Yeah, once it's all cleaned and everything, it's really, it's quite tasty on the grill, and many people have started trying it and encouraged them to try it. Because it's good.
Now, Red Snapper, that's excellent. Bake it in the oven cold.
Really?
Bake it in the oven with stewed tomatoes, peppers, onion, olive oil, garlic, and it's superb. That's almost like a Venezuelan style. I had it cold from Mexico one time, and I did it quite cold. It's excellent. Almost like chicken, you know, very sweet meat.
I have to try that. I don't know.
But if you're not a big fishy, you know, if you don't like
just like steaming them.
Yeah, steaming them. Yeah, right. Put them in the pan, scrub them up, put them in the pan, pour a cup of white wine, drizzle a little olive oil over it, a whole bunch of garlic, pull the lid down on the grill, and then neighbors will come over.
Yeah,
with a little Italian grip, the dipping, you know?
An occasional sea going too.
Yeah.
And these are blue point oysters. These are the top of the line oysters. Very, very sweet inside, nice and full and plump, not real sandy.
And no pearls.
Very seldom.
I mean, I haven't come across a pearl yet.
Yeah, 20 years. They're still working on that neck.
These are steamers.
Yes, steamers, or as they're called, pit clams. You call them steamers, it sounds a little more apt. That's the one with the little...
The tail?
Yeah.
Well, and the reason they call them piss clams is when you touch them,
sometimes they'll squirt. That's their defense mechanism. When they're under the water, their shell is so much softer than a regular hard shell clam. I mean, the shell will break very easily. And a crab, of course, will crush it. So what they do is they'll find a spot in the sand and they'll bury themselves down like this. And they start spitting up, and it makes a cloud. So then the crab can't crush them and whatnot. That's their only defense mechanism. And plus that, it's like a Dunkin' Donut candle.
That works.
And everybody knows what these are.
And these are mushrooms.
Oh, okay. No, I didn't know what they were.
You really didn't know.
No, I didn't.
They don't know all mushrooms. You can steam them, put them in a hot marinara sauce, or do them with garlic and wine, or garlic and oil.
I think I've ever seen mushrooms in a jar, so they must be without the shell.
Right. The new hot item now, though, is New Zealand mussels. That's the green shell mussel. Here. This claw is called a crusher claw, because that's what it does. If
I had gotten my finger stuck in one of the claws one time. He had the rubber band on. They just managed to open it just a little bit, and my finger got stuck in there. I had to go to the hospital. And he almost took my finger.
You want to touch it?
Sure. He's going to eat the base scallop.
Oh, wow.
And he is hungry, so he's been in the tank a while. And if you, if I drop a few base scallops in the tank, he'll actually start going, you know. And it's
wow.
They also shed, like crabs. A soft shell crab comes out of the shell. In order for this lobster to grow, the shell, this hard shell can't grow. So he has to come out of there. He will actually slip right out.
What they'll do is the shell will get hard, and that's how they grow. And they'll just keep growing and growing and growing.
The largest lobster that we've had in the store was 19¾ pounds.
Wow, that's pretty big.
This is only a pound and a half.
Oh, wow.
We carried him out of the cooler like a baby.
Oh, wow.
Well, give him the scallop after all that work.
Yeah, they'll fight over it, too.
Backing away, like, oh, he's frightened.
Once one of them senses that there's food in there, they usually start going for it. And they'll try and fight one another for it. Sometimes one will grab it out of the other's mouth or hands and they'll...
And they're gonna fight. They're gonna try and fight.
Yeah, the best way to cook lobster.
Well, you can broil them, you can bake them, you can barbecue them. To me, the best way to cook a lobster is to throw it in a pot of boiling water. It keeps the meat very moist and it never dries out. Sometimes when you're broiling, you over-broil and it gets tough, dry. To me, it stays juicy. You put them in the pot and boil them that size lobster, about 15 minutes, that's all.
Crabs, they'll fly.
The best parts of the lobster to eat are
the tail,
just the tail.
But no, there's meat and everything. There's meat, of course, in the claws, all the way up here. There's meat here. There's meat over here. There's meat in there behind the lungs. Okay, a lot of people don't know that. They just take the body and throw it away.
Right.
There's meat in here. And even if you suck hard enough, there's a little tiny piece of meat in here.
It's like a lot of work.
Yeah, it's a lot of work, but it's good. It's good. Okay, this is a soft shell crab. Like I was telling you with the lobsters, they shed their shells. Well, so do the crabs. That's how they grow. And this guy here, he's still wiggling. He's still alive. He would eat this whole thing.
Really?
Yeah, he'd eat the whole thing. The only thing you would do is you would pull this out. This is his lungs. Okay, that's not edible. Just like in the lobster, you find that in the lobster when you're eating it. And you would do both sides. You would pull them all out. And then you would flip the crab over on its back and you would pull this off. You don't need that. You don't need that part. And usually what I do, some people cut the face off to get the eyes off. I prefer to pull them out. Because what happens when you go to fry the crab or saute the crab, it falls apart. Like the top will come off the bottom because you cut the face. So I usually just cool it down. I pop the eyes out.
Thank you.
And if you can touch it, he's real soft. He can't, like all the other crabs running around the house, he can't actually bite you.
Wow, he's soft. Feels like something, but I can't really put my finger on what it is.
He doesn't bite, really.
Thank you. Oh, this is Mr. Salmon.
This is the salmon. I was showing you the salmon steaks before, and this is what comes from here.
Now, so you usually cut the head off, and then we steak it, and then probably like from here to the tail, we'll fillet it.
How many pounds is it?
This guy is about, I'd say
he's about 8 pounds. Okay, come on. We'll test to see how good she is.
Whoa!
She's bad. She's fired.
Off fire.
I was close.
Yeah, close.
I was thinking without the head.
Close by a mile.
Yeah, we're going to actually really do
sign, and they're pretty flexible in here. You don't think so? Okay, take a clam, and you hold it in your hand like that. You see that crevice there?
Spring, like this?
Just like that. Nope. You in there? There, right? Okay, now watch. Like this. And just pull it back. They're hard. It takes a little practice. Got it? You got it. All right, don't go in all the way. Now bring your knife out so just the tip is inside the clam. You got it. All right, now just scoop the tip of the knife. That's where the flexibility comes in. And bring it all the way along and turn the clam so you get to this side. And your clam's open. No?
Okay. Then go for it.
Come
Don't
on.
Touch yourself.
Yeah.
Now, now you got to twist the knife.
Twist your knife.
Okay,
good job.
Hey, there you go.
Yeah, now just fall apart. Hey. And you just
of
cut
course,
the clam out.
Of course, Rosemary's clam looks a lot more prettier than this does.
It's all right. Bill did a very good job. His first try. Okay, Bill.
First and only try.
Okay, Bill, we need 5 dozen on a half shell. Now. The customer's waiting.
And you have to rip off the top half.
You actually did 12 dozen in 10 minutes.
Yes.
Yeah, well, it was also probably like in July, and so
after
a while you build up calluses on your hand, and there really is an act.
Yeah.
You know, once you learn it's like all of a sudden you don't even think about it. I don't even think about it when I'm opening plants.
By the middle of July, she just does it so smoothly. She just keeps ripping them out.
Thank you. Well, being that you opened it, now you got to eat it.
Oh. Thank you, Nanette and Rose, for inviting us to their establishment, and they were nice enough to cook us a little snack.
And now I get to eat my clam.
Bye, Margaret.
Well, that's all the time we have for this week. If you would like to write us,
you can send your letters to Down the Shore,
P.O. Box 607,
Seaside Heights, New Jersey,
08751.
See you later.
We'll see you next week. Bye.
No, please. Don't toss her in there. She's the star.
Well. I know. I couldn't do that to the star.
Nobody wants to say the first goodbye. Every time I see you cry. I know it's true. Now I'm the fool.